together our senior class schedules, Morgan and I were both looking for the most difficult classes we could take to look on our college applications. Our counselors recommended that we continue a two-part research-based program. The classes they suggested involved writing a 4,000 to 5,000 word research paper on a topic of interest.
At the time, we thought this meant searching through a bunch of scholarly databases about our desired topics, for example, climate change and stress, and compiling it into a nice paper.
On our first day of class, we realized that that was not the case.
Our teacher, Ms. Charlo, broke the news to us that this class actually involved conducting our original research, compiling our findings into a 20-plus page paper and presentation for our final exam in April.
From here, we embarked on a 9-month journey of screaming, hair pulling, and tears.
While this process was frustrating at times, the reward was worth it. We have walked away with the experience of designing and conducting our own research.
This was a unique process that we learned, and we were very thankful that we learned it. It was very beneficial to us, but we realized that many high schoolers don't have the opportunity that we have.
We believe that all high schoolers must be given the opportunity to conduct their own research for three main reasons. One, it allows students to be able to discover and explore their passions. It is useful for college, and it puts your education to the test.
So, before we discuss why we believe that it is beneficial for high school students to do research, we first would like to define what research is. In a normal English class, a research paper is a compilation of theories on a specific topic. For example, when I was a freshman in high school, I wrote a paper on the Great Fire of London. I searched the phrase Great Fire of London in Google and took all of the information that I found and put it into a paper. Most people think that this is what research is and this is what writing a research paper is. That's what we thought, but that is actually incorrect. We are defining research as an investigative process in which one collects data to come to a new understanding of a topic of interest. We call this capital R research. In our research-based class, we had to come up with a topic of interest and formulate a question to which the answer has not yet been found. So basically, we had to do a study on something that no one has ever done before.
So why should high schoolers do original research? At the beginning of our research class, we had to decide what our topic of interest was going to be. This research in high school helps students decide early on what they want to do for future careers and majors. I never considered myself to be a science person. I always thought I would end up majoring in political science and do something in that realm. But my topic of interest ended up being on zero waste, more of an environmental science study. And so I've actually now decided to try to find a way when I get to college to combine those two things into my major to find a career that targets both of my passions. High schoolers are able to do their own research to dig deeper into their passions, but they're also able to discover passions that they never thought they would have.
So the second reason why we believe that high schoolers should do research is because it will be useful for them in college and beyond. The research that we conducted is similar to a senior thesis. We have completed graduate level work as seniors in high school. We learned how to write literature reviews, design our own research method, implement that research method, and synthesize and analyze data, all under the guidance of a teacher in a classroom setting. We learned, analyzed, and conducted this meticulous process with the help of a teacher. We weren't just thrown into it. Because we have learned how to do this process in high school, it will be easier for us if and when we decide to do research in college. Our peers will be learning as they go, but we will have already had the experience and we will already understand the process much better. Right now, Morgan and I and our classmates are in the process of publishing the research that we have recently completed. Students who conduct research in high school can do this as well and become published researchers before they even reach college.
By the time we're seniors in high school, we have spent 12 years sitting at desks listening to our teachers lecture on about topics that we don't actually understand how they are applicable in the real world. Many students find themselves sitting in classes feeling that they will never use this information in world history and calculus, and wonder why they need to learn this information now. Doing research allows the discovery of how these subjects can lead to future careers and majors in international relations and engineering. Students must be intrinsically motivated and engaged in the research process, combining all the information that they've learned from the past year, from the past 12 years of their studies. Research is a hands-on experience, and it's not just something that you can observe. You get out what you put into it.
So how can high schoolers engage in their own research? We believe that anyone can do research. Anyone sitting in this room can do their own research. Students who have an intense curiosity in a certain field might as well get started now. This could be in anything ranging from math to science or to history.
In this global age, there are so many different ways to be involved in research, whether that is in a classroom or if it's in student-initiated clubs or after-school activities.
We believe that high schools should offer more hands-on research-based classes so that students can learn how to conduct and design their own studies with the help of a teacher. We know that this might not be possible for all schools, as some schools may have a lack of teachers who have experience in the research field, but there are many ways that other students can get involved in research.
For example, there are so many different STEM projects and competitions for students who are interested in the sciences to participate in.
Students can also get involved in high school summer internship programs, or even initiate conversations with local college professors so that they can engage in a research project of their own interest.
Our experience with research, as frustrating and confusing as it was well worth it and gave us the knowledge that we will carry throughout college and graduate school. We believe that this must become a norm in all high school education programs.
If you are passionate about something, we encourage you to dive deeper and engage in your own research. Thank you.